Well, Christine, coming back from substantial injury as well, that ruptured left quadricep, which we're told has healed but continued to trouble her through the season. And there's the lineup. First four to qualify, remember, plus four fastest losers. Very good athlete out in lane eight, Rosemary White, the Jamaican, and in lane three, Antonina Krivoshapka, the Russian, European bronze medalist and world bronze medalist a couple of years ago. So, Christine Ohuruogu on form. For what we've seen, she's got it to do. The athletes go forward to their blocks once more. A lot of noise around the arena. Other events taking place at the same time. But we're concentrating for the moment on the women's 400 metres, and this is the third heat of the first round. Judges appear to be satisfied. Now, false start. Oh, dear, 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 dear. Christine Ohuruogu holds her hand in dismay, and that is going to be the end of her World Championships. It is a personal disaster for her, and she looks stunned, bemused, bewildered, and now trying to fight back the tears.
I can't believe what I've just seen. The experience of Christine Ohuruogu, a former world champion. It's a 400 meters, it's not a final, it's a longer sprint. So to go out to a false start shows the nerves, I think, of an athlete. The red card has come out. He's asking the athlete in lane five, wearing number 397, the former world champion from Great Britain and Northern Ireland, Christine Ohuruogu, to please leave the track.
Well, for British athletics, for Christine Ohuruogu, that is an awful image. Let's hope she gets it right 12 months from now. She's had a miserable year, and that really just compounds what has happened. Look again at how it happened. And clearly, well, that's the easiest piece of judging that the starter has had so far.
It was a clear false start. And I genuinely can't find any reason to explain to our listeners here on Channel 4 of why an Olympic champion has gone out in a heat in a 400 metres with a false start. And the worst thing is, I don't think she knows herself.
Of all the people that could have happened to it, it had to be me. The slowest starters before starting a 400. It's very ironic.
With everything you've been, Phil, did you just feel you needed to get a good start because you were playing catch-up, in a sense, after your injury?
I just wanted to get a good start. I wanted to get out. I knew it was going to be a fast round. I mean...
I know, deep breath.
I can't believe it.
At the point that the gentleman came with the red card, you had his... your back to him, but did you know it was you straight away?
I knew it was me, but I just thought maybe somehow it might not have been me, but I knew it was a bit.
Did you feel, despite all your injury problems, that you were in shape here to do yourself justice?
I mean, I worked really hard to turn the last 3 weeks around, and I'm just right now I'm just really kind of upset for my coach. He worked really hard to get me in shape, and I really do feel bad for him. I feel really bad for him because he just worked so hard. It's been a hard year for both of us, but he worked really hard keeping me, you know, motivated. So it's just so ironic.
Well, I'm grateful to you for talking to us, Christine. Hard lines, but thank you for taking it on the chin.